Good morning, everyone out there in the internet. I am making a video because I was wrong about dandelion. It's actually sow thistle. So I made a video a while back about making some stuff, some essence, a tincture out of what I thought was dandelion. It is not dandelion. It is sow thistle. So this is a retraction video. and also a really great reason for me to go to herb school is to learn the differences between the plants. I thought it was because they look really similar. And it turns out they have similar functions, but they're different plants. Dandelion, I found out, I will share with you, is always really short and close to the ground. It doesn't get very tall. Sow thistle can be up to 6 feet tall, and has different arrangements of flowers. So I thought I would share some facts about sow thistle, which I can show you in my garden. It is quite large and was in the last video I talked about, like, releasing anger. Its nickname is Lion's Paw. It has a rosette of leaves at the base along the stem, and it has yellow dandelion-like flower heads, but they occur in several clusters at the end of the stems. And they have, like, similar medical functions. I was, like, kind of hesitant about doing a video with, like, I'm gonna talk about a specific plant before I went to herb school, because I might be wrong. You know, it's time for me to go to herb school, because I was wrong, and I'm disseminating false information on the internet. So thanks for everybody's, patience and grace as I go through this learning process. But what is really interesting is that it also, like, has liver function, which is related to processing anger, and is, like, something that comes up in the spring as well. The leaves are edible, which is great because I totally ate them. I put them in a soup. I ate the roots, and I, like, fed the essence to my friends with the flowers. What's interesting about it is it's also what's called a cathartic. So it served a similar process of, like, moving something through my body. And I think it, you know, even the process of, like, digging up, like, you know, 50 of these roots out of the garden was a cathartic process. So it's, I don't know, it's really interesting to watch the process that I'm going through, learning about plants, like, using what's immediately in front of me, and, yeah, like, hitting some of the bumps and learning along the way, because, yeah, it was really important for me in that moment to, like, use what we had, which was the sow thistle that was, like, everywhere, in this house, because we were facing eviction, and going through this really, really stressful process as a house. We're in the Elmwood neighborhood of Berkeley, in South Berkeley. It's really expensive. And as a house, we were processing, like, a lot of anger and grief and fear. And so what was present outside was these sow thistles. They were just coming up. So, you know, something in me was like, use those. So, you know, whatever process, like, we went through was the right one, because that's how we did it, and so it's really interesting, to come through it and be like, okay, like, this plant wasn't what I thought it was, but in the end, it still served me, and hopefully us, but yeah, but that's a lesson in, like, doing more research and being more diligent before I present material and present medicine to other people, is being, like, 100% sure I know what I'm doing. So thank you for helping me stay in line with that, and as I document this whole process. And thank you for, you know, like, helping me get access to, like, real education so that I don't feed people random things. Alrighty, I hope everyone has a super amazing, beautiful spring day. And I love you all. Goodbye.